Thank you. Dr. Nimal Singh, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and to all people of Jammu, a Josh Wala Jai Hind. It is such a pleasure to come back to Jammu, always. This is my Karam Bhumi. Nearly four decades of service. 2 months ago, I retired after 4 decades of service. I am from Jammu and Kashmir Light Infantry. All the troops, all my boys are from Jammu and around. I have 8 Jackala is my battalion, bravest of the brave battalion. Bana Singh Paramveer Chakra is from my battalion. We grew up together in the same battalion. I have served, I was telling Anirban when we were seeing mountains from the air this morning, I was saying, कैप्टन से लेके मेजर से लेके जनरल तक पहले मैं पैदल चलता था इन पहाड़ों में उसके बाद पेट्रोलिंग की है एनकाउंटर लड़े हैं एज ए कर्नल एंड एज ए मेजर और एज अ कोर कमांडर आई हैव बीन फ्लाइंग ओवर द हिल्स एंड देन माउंटेंस बोथ साइड्स ऑफ इट सो इट्स सच अ प्लेजर टू कम बैक हियर जम्मू एंड कश्मीर लाइट इन्फेंट्री इज अ इज आवर सन्स ऑफ द सॉइल हियर जेएनके वी गॉट द only Ashok Chakra yesterday and for the first time it is a terrorist turned soldier and a brave one at that so these are hopefully they will inspire some of the youth to come back to the right path main Jammu Kashmir light infantry ke bare mein last sentence ye bolna chahta hu ki maine navratri mein fast rakha hai ramzan mein roze rakhe hain गुरुद्वारे में जाके लंगर छका है मतलब हमारे मंदिर मस्जिद गुरुद्वारा हमारी एमएमजी होती है एक छत के नीचे जैकलाई रेजिमेंट में मंदिर मस्जिद गुरुद्वारा होते हैं डॉक्टर नरेंद्र सिंह जब डिप्टी चीफ मिनिस्टर थे मेरे साथ इफ्तार के लिए जब मैं कोर कमांडर था वहाँ गए थे सो इट इज सच अ प्लेजर टू कम बैक हियर एंड अनिर्बान सेड सम वेरी नाइस वर्ड्स एज टू व्हाई वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम जम्मू सो आई वोंट रिपीट ऑल दैट एज अ सोल्जर आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू about how I've seen as a senior officer in the last few years, and I'm not talking about any government, and I'm talking about what has happened in the last couple of years. What changes we have seen in, let's talk about securing India. What is security? It is our job as Army, Navy, Air Force, to safeguard the country. What do we safeguard? Borders. But what are the borders? Are the borders? With Pakistan, line of actual control with China. But are these the only borders? Borders are also getting redefined. What about the cyber world? There are no borders, there are no boundaries, space. So there are new dimensions that are coming in. Nitin spoke about everybody calling it Doklam. That is the info warfare in our mind space. जो कश्मीरी टेररिस्ट के साथ भी हम करते हैं वी आर ट्राइंग टू गेट इनटू हिज माइंड बट हिज माइंड हैज ऑलरेडी बीन टेकन बाय समबडी एल्स सो दिस इज अनदर रियलिटी दैट वी हैव टू कंटेंड विद एंड लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस फॉर वन मोर पॉइंट बिफोर मूविंग ऑन हु इज द टारगेट हु इज द एनिमी इज ऑल गेटिंग ब्लर्ड नाउ अभी टारगेट क्या है वो पहले तो सोल्जर टू सोल्जर लड़ाई होती थी उसको हम कोलैटरल डैमेज बोलते थे दैट मीन्स Some civilians who die, the villages next to the LOC. आपने देखे हैं जे जम्मू रीजन में कश्मीर में हर जगह सो दैट वॉज कोलेटरल डैमेज बट टूडे मे बी मेरे से ज्यादा यू आर एट रिस्क एट द बस स्टॉप एट द रेलवे स्टेशन इन द मार्केट सो देन यू आर द टारगेट्स यू मीन सिविलियंस आर द टारगेट्स वॉट हैपन्ड विद त्रिवेणी सिंह ऑफ माई रेजिमेंट गॉट अशोक चक्र इट वॉज रेलवे स्टेशन दैट वॉज अटैक्ड इन जम्मू सो वी आर लुकिंग एट अ वेरी डिफरेंट वॉरफेयर The changing nature of warfare. So we have to do two things in our country. We have to continue to guard the conventional borders, boundaries, line of LOCs, LAC, etc. For which we have to modernize, and I'll come to that. But for the changing nature of warfare, we require a shift in our mindsets. We have to change our mindset to get ready कि नहीं ये भी लाई है cyber warfare. China has got 40,000 or there are some figures is 400,000 cyber warriors and they are attacking our systems. When one day Bangalore airport was stopped for 6 hours, was it really a software failure or was somebody trying out unki power kitni hai? So we have to see. Once you remember Air India website was hacked. It happened very recently last year when it was hacked. It was hacked by somebody. Or our army ka, there was a CDA thing was hacked. So these are the warfares. Why they are more important? We won't have to kinetic warfare because they are very, those things are very expensive. Okay, I'll come to that later. But now conventional warfare. That does not mean that we don't have to guard our borders. We have to, for which conventional military is required. So first talking about that, we need to modernize. The world over, the armies are modernizing, technologies are changing, we need to modernize. For more than a decade actually, military did not get a lot of equipment that we need. Some controversy or the other, after Bofors we haven't got a gun. Okay, controversy of Bofors happened for 30 years, more than 3 decades, we didn't get a gun till last year. When I say gun, some of us understand, I'm talking of artillery guns, Topkhana. So we've got our guns for the first time last year to buy some aircraft. So now what has happened in the recent past is that we have started modernizing. There was a hiatus, there was a total inaction for some time, for more than a decade. We have started now acquiring things. We have started going where it is required to the foreign vendors and buying warlike, war fighting equipment and ammunition. But more important than that, for the first time, our private industry when India got independence was not very strong. So our country had to start what we call PSUs. So the government had to get into industries, whether it is HAL or HMT, everything, watches to aircrafts were being made by the government because the private industry was very nascent in 1947. But over the last 7 decades, our private industry can be compared globally to the best. So in every field, from automotive to all kind of software, hardware, everywhere, we have gone ahead. So I think it was high time that the government decided that it is high time we encourage the private players, the private industry, to come into the defense sector. But that's not possible because we don't have technologies. They're going to take a long time to get technologies. These are technologies nobody gives easily. The other countries don't give it, even friendly nations. They want you to buy the equipment. 2 years ago, I was Chief of Integrated Defense Staff and I had just gone, taken over. More than 2 years ago, we drafted a policy called Strategic Partnership, in which the government wanted to give incentives so that the private sector, a private industry house, will partner with a foreign industry who makes, let's say, aircrafts or helicopters or submarines, and then they will partner but manufacture in India. With this, we will get the technology, our workers will acquire the skill sets, and after they give us what we want, what is required for Army, Navy, Air Force and Coast Guard and other forces, then with the kind of skill sets available, with the low or a reasonable cost of labor in India, we will be able to then be able to actually export from here. Look at China. Because China has demand and China has the money, Boeing has set up a factory there. Why should we not do it over here? The amount of rifles that our country needs is humongous. And if we count in the police forces, CRPF, state police, if you set up a big factory anywhere, the number of rifles that we can, the moment we finish supplying our forces, we would always already be requiring a resupply for the first lot. So my point is, with the kind of magnitudes that we require technology. And for the first time, there's something called strategic partnership has been worked out. It is work in progress. Already, 2 or 3 cases are moving where industry is going to come in. Thereafter, once they start manufacturing, with the kind of reasonable labor cost we have, we will be able to export. And once we actually, India starts exporting, say, ammunition or weapon or equipment, it will be so reasonable compared to the Western countries. It will be a win-win situation. We can actually be a driver, an engine for economic growth as well. So this is a big policy shift. Now, a lot of us are not aware. Actually, I was also fighting in Kashmir, and I was also not aware of this till I went to Delhi. Then I remember now Nitin has started another organization where Bharat Shakti, he comes out and he explains these things in a forum called Bharat Shakti that he does. So this is one part. Now, coming to the other issue where I said that we need to have create capabilities for a new thing, cyber, space. Because space today, satellites are going to control the world. Information is going to be controlled by UAVs. Forget about that bird that you saw in picture, Woody, that is so, at least now it is fanciful, but birds are being developed. And mind you, birds, the big bird, big birds are also being developed, but there are these small birds, like insects, like mosquitoes, these small birds, and they go in swarms. Imagine if you have those small things, they require very little battery. But each one has got a very small camera that sees into this. And there are 5,000 of them. They fly like this in this room. But there is artificial intelligence to integrate the pictures of all those cameras. And then somebody here, when Dr. Nirmal Singh is seeing in his screen, he gets the integrated picture. And that swarm can actually go through windows, go through that grill, and go through keyholes. My point is, this is not a flight of fantasy. So we have to prepare ourselves. That, ladies and gentlemen, actually requires courage. That requires stepping out of the line. We can't prepare for it after we have been attacked. Although I will concede, we are late. US, Russia, China, the Western world has gone far ahead. But for the first time, this government, last year, and I mean, since I was in heading the IDS, we have now started the process of having a cyber command, raising a space command division, an armed forces, that is Army, Navy, Air Force, commandos all together to meet any contingencies that may arise. Imagine this was a recommendation of group of ministers led by Mr. Advani in 2001 after Kargil war. But there has been a fair amount of inaction from then to now. We have not been able to go beyond. We raised headquarter IDS. We did not appoint CDS. The country did not appoint CDS. And I was a poor substitute, one level below CDS who was heading. That is, I did that for 2 years. But we raised Andaman Nicobar Command and we raised a Strategic Forces Command, which handled the strategic weapons. And you know what I'm talking about. So that was done in 2000, between 2001 and in a couple of years after that. After that, we didn't do anything. Till last year, eventually, after a lot of persuasion, we have managed to have. So the government has signed for cyber, space, and armed forces special operation division. Now, I took 3-4 minutes to explain why this is required. Ladies and gentlemen, this is required. This cyber warfare is the warfare of future. But does it only affect the military? No, like I said, it can affect anybody and everybody. So therefore, it is required also to integrate the other side. So NTRO, intelligence agencies, then there is a Ministry of Electronic and IT. So that ministry has to be integrated so that our essential services, whether it is banking or power grids, railways, all these essential service, critical infrastructure has to be protected. To enmesh and synergize all these, there is a requirement of a body which looks at different ministries. In our country, ministries don't talk to each other very easily. So I know I'm saying that in front of you, sir, but ministries don't talk to each other. If you want to put up an industry, your foreign ministry will not give you clearance. You want to make a road over there, then some environment ministry somebody will not give you clearance. So it is very difficult. Sorry. So another bold step was taken. I beg your pardon. There was something called Defense Planning Committee, a very lean committee with 3 secretaries, finance, under the chairmanship of NSA, that brings in the PMO. Rest secretaries were invited when they were required. That means as on required on an invitation basis, depending on what was being discussed. So there is a requirement to integrate different instruments of power. Because wars will not only remain confined to cyber and space. Today, trade has become another war. That's another way of sort of subjugating or intimidating another country or pressurizing a country. So much so for integrating and creating new structures, which is really a big lever the government has taken last year. At the operational level, before I talk about much talk of surgical strikes, we had some critical words. You read about this in the Army, Navy, Air Force. For the first time, the government, 2 years ago or 2.5 years ago, maybe 3 years ago, you can correct me, somewhere there when I was in Kashmir, they for the first time delegated powers to the vice chiefs of Army, Navy and Air Force to make up our war waging potential up to 10 days of war. I know it may sound a little high flown. 10 din ki ladai ke liye jitna aapko chahiye Army, Navy, Air Force apne aap khareed sakte hain. We don't have to take sanction. We don't have to go to the ministry to take sanction. That suddenly, you know, we have had in the past some chief, some general retired or serving saying, "Hamari hollowness hai." It just takes the wind out of your sail because ab aapko powers de di, aap apne aap kariye, and we are doing it. So now you are empowered. Sashakt banta hai desh aisi cheezon se. On the other side, in operations, actually in the field, Nitin mentioned Doklam, and of course he corrected, and I correct myself, Dolam. The Dolam Plateau, that area, what was it? We stood up to China for the first time. China thought that we're not going to stand up. In Jammu, we stood up in style. We brought overbearing forces. He gave you the figures. 900 men go there. Look at the kind of standoff that we did. Again, without firing a shot. And then, of course, there were backroom diplomacy, and so being diplomat, being reasonable there. So that was a strategy. That's what we did. Myanmar, he spoke about the strikes there. That was a friendly country. But the groups, the terrorist groups, were operating from across, and we did not hesitate to go inside again for the first time. What happened in surgical strikes was Uri. We talk of the movie, but Uri. You imagine my plight when I go there on 18th of September. One Sunday, I wake up and casualties start happening. Two more died. And I'm getting this information when I landed up in Uri, it was all burning. And we lost 19 soldiers. Sometime before that, we had EDI building. We had so many casualties. Remember, EDI building is in Pampore outside Srinagar, it happened. On 2nd of January that year, I'm talking about 2016, Pathankot, so much closer over here, Pathankot happened. They go inside up. So when these things were happening, not that they weren't happening earlier, when these things were happening day in and day out, Uri was the last straw. So somewhere we decided that a bold riposte has to be taken, a bold strike. Now what is bold? Like Nitin also said, things have happened earlier, not that they haven't happened, but very, very, very shallow, very at a very smaller scale. Having this ceasefire violation, little bit of here and there. But in this case, it was decided that we have to show, the country has to show their resolve and the capacity and the capability to be able to execute it. But most importantly, like you said, own up after that. So for the first time, the government stood up and said, yes, we did it because you did that to us. Don't you have, there is a bomb attack, a grenade attack, and then some group owns up. So instead of saying, no, we didn't do it, it off, like whenever there is an attack, bad action or border attacks on LOC, the dignitaries who come from Pakistan on TV shows, they say, no, ye to inki homegrown insurgency hai, to aapas mein aapke terrorist hai, hamare to log aaye nahi. But no, he said, we have done it. And we have done it because you did UDI, you did Pakistan, you did XYZ. So we did it. Thank you. So here it was to show the resolve. The country said, we have done it. Now, what is the signal that it sends? It is not that, like he said, it is not that the problem is resolved with one surgical strike. It is not. But it throws a caution in their mind that we can do it. We can do it again. A lot of people have asked me in the press and reporters, so will we have another one? Why haven't we had another one? How will the next? You, but the next one will not be this way. What it will be, we can't talk. But I'm sure there'll be, there are other ways of doing it. So the idea was that we have shown our capacity, our resolve. What will happen next time remains to be seen. So ladies and gentlemen, these are the kind of things that we've done, and saving the best for the last. I was Chief of Integrated Defence Staff, and for me, my biggest charter was to integrate Army, Navy and Air Force. World over, they are integrated. Most of the big militaries have integrated their structures, we have not. Where we don't have a CDS, CGS or call it whatever. We can do a lot of a developing country like India, we need to integrate because there's a lot of resource optimization. There is a lot of resource, all our resources can be optimized if we do things together. Sanja Chula. So we need to do it together. And then it also enhances our. Since I was responsible for this, Prime Minister personally, I still remember 21st January the conference of 2017, the date, in Dehradun, he says, I give you 1 month, show me four areas you have integrated. He gave this orders to the chiefs. So, you know, this kind of thing. So, we have gone great steps to synergize between the Army, Navy, Air Force. We have also synergized between the various organs of different ministries and various instruments of power, I should say. We have gone ahead to modernize our present capability points and to create new structures where newer structures are required. And if we need this trust to continue to secure India. Thank you very much.